Hello children, namaste everyone. Welcome back to the mathematics class. Dear children, in our last videos we have studied what is a quadratic equation and how to find the roots of the quadratic equation. So let us recall what we have studied in our last videos. What do you mean by quadratic equation? An equation in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, and the value of the roots or roots of the quadratic equation can be calculated by different methods. One is factorization method, another one is completing the square, and another method is by using formula. So about factorization we have seen in our last video, and completing the square method, that is related from the syllabus. And today we will study how to find the roots of the quadratic equation using formula. So there is a simple formula. If we apply that formula, we can easily find the roots of the quadratic equation. Before that, a quadratic equation has two roots. How many roots? Two roots. So two roots of the quadratic equation can be calculated by using one formula. So what is that formula? See, if a quadratic equation is given, see, for example, I will write a quadratic equation. See, x square plus x square minus 7x plus 10 is equal to 0. This is one quadratic equation. X square minus 7x plus 10 is equal to 0. See, how to find the value of the roots or roots of the quadratic equation using formula? See, there is a suitable formula. That formula is called quadratic formula. Okay, the question may be like this in the examination: find the roots of the quadratic equation using quadratic formula, or using formula find the roots of the quadratic equation, or by formula method find the roots of the quadratic equation. These are the different ways of asking the question. Okay, what is that formula? See, that formula is like this. See, remember properly, one simple formula: roots of the quadratic equation, see, x, if x is the root of the quadratic equation, it can be calculated by the formula x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So this is the formula to find the root of a quadratic equation. See, x is equal to minus b, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. This 2a till here, from here to here to whole. What is that in the numerator? See, you have to write this 2a not only for this b square minus 4ac, it is to whole. What is there in the numerator? Okay, so this is the formula: x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Let us solve one question. Say x square, so x square minus 7x plus 10 is equal to 0. So how to find the value of this roots of the quadratic equation? See, before that we have to see whether that given equation is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 or not. If it is not there, first you have to bring that equation to that formula. For example, if it is like this, if it is given like this, x square minus 7x is equal to 10. If it is given like this, what is the meaning of this? X square minus 7x is equal to minus 10. If the equation is in this form, so you have to bring that equation to the form of x square, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. See, it is not in that form. See, c is in the right hand side. So bring it. X square minus 7x. If you bring minus 10 to the left hand side, it becomes plus 10 is equal to 0. So if the equation is not in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then you have to bring that equation to that form. Okay. Next, so suppose this is the equation: x square minus 7x plus 10 is equal to 0. Understand properly. How to, which are the different steps you have to write? First you have to write, if the equation is given like this, this is in the form, after bringing that equation to the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, then you have to write, this is in the form, this means this equation is in the form, of what? Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. You have to bring that form where a is equal to, what is a here? What is that in the place of a? See, ax square, a is how much? X square, here what is 1x square? So a is equal to 1, x square means 1x square. A is equal to 1, b is equal to, what is b? B is equal to minus 7. In the place of b, minus 7 is there, not plus 3. See, it is not plus 7x, it is minus 7x. Therefore, b is equal to minus 7 and c is equal to 10. See here, t. See, in the place of c, 10 is there, plus 10, c is equal to 10. You are right, this is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a is equal to 1, b is equal to minus 7, c is equal to 10. Okay, then you are right in the form again. So, x is equal to minus b, plus or minus, square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Apply the formula, write the formula and apply the values to the formula. So minus b, you see minus b, what is b? That is equal to minus b. What is minus b? Minus b means what? B means minus 7. Therefore, it becomes minus of minus 7. Isn't it? See, minus b means, this minus is, what is there in the formula? Value of b is minus 7, therefore minus of minus 7 plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac. What is b square? B square, apply the value, b is minus 7, so minus 7 square minus 4 into a, a means 1, c means 10, so minus 4ac divided by 2a. Look here, divided by 2a, what is a? A is equal to 2 into 1. Yes, now minus of minus 7, minus b means minus of minus 7, minus of minus 7 is plus 7, plus or minus, see here, plus or minus root minus 7 square. What is minus 7 square? Minus 7 into minus 7, minus 7, 7 into 7, 49, minus into minus, plus. So minus 7 square means plus 49, minus 4 into 1 into 10, minus 4 into 1, minus 4, minus 4 into 10, minus 40, minus 40 divided by 2 into 1, 2. Okay, so 7, so how it becomes? 7 plus or minus, that is equal to 7 plus or minus square root of 49 minus 40. What is 49 minus 40? That is 9. 49 minus 40 is equal to 9 divided by 2. So that is equal to 7 plus or minus root 9, square root of 9 is equal to how much? Root 9, it is 3 divided by 2. Therefore, two values are there, to any quadratic equation there are two roots. So which are the two roots? See, one root is 7 plus 3 divided by 2 or 7 minus 3 divided by 2. So this is the value. So 7 plus 3 divided by 2 or 7 minus 3 divided by 2. So what is 7 plus 3? 7 plus 3 is equal to 10, 10 divided by 2, or 7 minus 3 is equal to 4, 4 divided by 2. Therefore, 10 divided by 2 is 5, or 4 divided by 2 is 2. So these are the two roots. Therefore, the two roots of the quadratic equation is 5 or 2. So 5 or 2 are the roots of the quadratic equation x square minus 7x plus 10 is equal to 0. Like this, we can solve a quadratic equation. So you must remember this formula. If you remember this formula, you can find the value of this. See, so this is about finding the value of quadratic equation using quadratic formula. Okay, we will solve one more problem. See, 2x square minus 4x minus 5 is equal to 0. So how you have to write it? This is in the form of, this is in the form, it is in the form ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a is equal to 2, b is equal to minus 4, c is equal to minus 5, not plus 5, it is minus 5. Now apply the formula, x is equal to minus b plus or minus minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. So apply the formula, apply the value to the formula. Minus b, minus b means minus of minus 4, plus or minus square root of b square minus 4 whole square. See, my b means minus 4 minus b whole square minus 4 into a. A means 2 and c. C means minus 5. Look here. So minus 4 into 2 into minus 5. C is equal to minus 5. Divided by 2a. 2 into a. A means 2. So a is equal to. Okay. Now minus of minus 4. It is plus 4 plus or minus square root of minus 4 whole square. Minus 4 into minus 4 plus 16 minus plus 16. Next is a minus 4 into 2 minus 8. Minus 8 into minus 5. 8 into 5 14. Is it? 40. Minus into minus is plus. See, minus 4 into 2 minus 8. Yeah? Minus 8 into minus 5 minus plus 40. See, it is minus 4ac together. Is it b square minus 4ac? 4ac. This is the value of 4ac. Okay. Divided by 2 into 2 is 4. So 4 plus or minus square root of 16 plus 40. So how to solve this? So you have to add this. So 4, that is equal to 4 plus or minus 16 plus 40 is 56 divided by 4. Divided by 4. So if you can't solve this 56, you can't simplify this 56. Suppose if it is 60, we will write it as 4 into 6. 4 into 12, like that you can split 4 into 12, if it is 60, isn't it? See, root 60, how you can write 4 into 12, 4 into 12, if you bring 4, you can write like this, 2 root 12, like this you will write. But it is here 56, so we can't solve this question, solve this 56, root 56, so you have to keep it as such. So here there are 2 roots, so which are the 2 roots? 1 root is 4 plus root 56 divided by 4 or 4 minus root 56 divided by 4. So these are the two roots of this equation. So one root is 4 plus root 56 divided by 4 and another one is 4 minus root 56 divided by 4. See, plus or minus, isn't it? These are the two values. So like this we will find the value of the quadratic equation or roots of the quadratic equation using quadratic formula. Okay. Next, so this is about to find the value of quadratic equation. Now, what about the roots of the quadratic equation? Nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. See, nature of the roots. See, to find the nature of the roots. See, suppose how to find the nature of the roots if the quadratic equation is given. For example, x square minus 7x plus 10 is equal to 0. What about the nature? See, in that equation, only b square minus 4ac, it is that the square root of b square minus 4ac, it is that in the formula, square root of b square minus 4ac. See, if you find only b square minus 4ac, this is, see, you, if you apply the values of b square minus 4ac, it decides the nature of the roots. It's enough. B square minus 4ac. So, if b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, if it is more than 0, means what? 1, 2, 3, 4, like all positive numbers. More than 0, isn't it? So, if it is more than 0, the roots are real, distinct and real roots. What is the meaning distinct and real roots? Distinct and real roots means, if you solve this equation, at the end you will get two distinct roots, different roots, and it must be real number. It should be a real number. See, plus x is equal to plus 2 or x is equal to minus 5. See, these are the real roots. 2 and 5 are the real numbers, but they are distinct. It is not same. Both the roots are different roots. Distinct means different roots. Okay. So if b square minus 4ac is greater than 0, it is also called discriminant. Okay. So discriminant means what? So b square minus 4ac of a quadratic equation is called the discriminant. If it is greater than 0, the roots are distinct and real roots, or that roots are different, different roots. Two roots are different, but it is a real number. Next, if the b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, if you get b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then you will get equal and real roots. What I mean equal and real roots? If you solve any question at the end, you will get two values like this, x is equal to 5 or x is equal to 5. Both the roots are equal, like this, both the roots, same number comes. Whatever it may be, it may be negative or positive, but both the roots are equal and it is real. So real number, 5 and 5 real. So if b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, then the roots are equal and real. Okay. If b square minus 4ac is less than 0, less than means negative numbers, or less than 0 means what? Or negative numbers. If b square minus 4ac of equation is, or discriminant of equation is less than 0, then the roots are what? If the roots are no real roots. It is not a real number. It comes like this. X is equal to what? 2 plus plus root. See, now we got 156 divided by 2. This is not a real number. Root 56 is not a real number. Is it? It is not a real number. No specific value for this. So like this value comes. Now we have solved the question. That is what? It is the discriminant of that equation is less than 0. Okay, only discriminant is less than 0, then the nature of the root is no real roots. Okay, now let us solve some questions. So let us find the discriminant roots of the equation. 4x square plus 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. See, this is one equation. Find the discriminant of the root. Discriminant of the root. What is the discriminant of the root? Here a is equal to 4, b is equal to plus 2, c is equal to plus 3. So b square minus 4ac, this is a discriminant, is how much? B square minus 4ac. See, b square, 2 square minus 4 into a is also 4 into c is 3. See, 2 square is equal to 4. Next, 4ac means how? Minus 4ac is how much? Minus 4 into 4. 4 4s are 16. 16 minus 16. Minus 16 into 3. Minus 16 into 3. How much? Minus 16 into 3. 48. So, minus 16 into 3 is 48. Minus 48. So, 4 minus 48 is how much? Minus 44. See, here, value of this b square minus 4ac in this equation is minus 44. What about minus 44? Whether it is less than 0 or equal to 0 or more than 0? It is less than 0. Minus 44 is less than 0. Therefore, b square minus 4ac is less than 0. Therefore, in that equation, there is no specific roots, no real roots. Okay? You will get the no real numbers. It is no real roots. So, like that, you can find out. Let us find the nature of the another equation. See, quadratic equation. See, 2x square plus 6x plus 4 is equal to 0. The equation is like this. What is the nature of the roots? A is equal to 2, b is equal to 6, c is equal to 4. B square minus 4ac is equal to b square, 6 square minus 4 into 2 into 4. 6 square is 36, isn't it? 6 square is 36 minus 4 into 2 is 8. 8 into 4 is 32. That is equal to, what is the answer? 4 plus 4. Now plus 4, what is the meaning? Plus 4 is what? It is b square minus 4ac is greater than 0. Therefore, you will get, if you solve this equation, at the end you will get two roots. That roots are distinct and real roots. Distinct means x is two different values and they are real numbers. Minus 2 or plus 5 or plus 3 and plus 8. Whatever they be, like that. Distinct and real roots. So it is enough. To find the nature of the roots, it's enough if you find only b square minus 4ac. Okay, which are the roots of the equation? Let us solve that equation using the formula. We got in the equation 2x square minus 6x plus 4 is equal to 0. What are the nature of the roots? distinct and real, isn't it? Distinct and real. Let us solve that equation. How to? Using the formula we will solve. What the formula says? Formula. Yeah, this is in the form of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. Like that you are right. Where a is equal to b is equal to minus 6, c is equal to 4. Isn't it? Yes. Now x is equal to minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Now minus b minus of minus 6 plus or minus minus 6 whole square minus 4ac 4 into 2 into 4 divided by 2a 2 into 2. See, minus of minus 6 is plus 6 plus or minus square root of minus 6 whole square is 36, minus 4 into 2 is minus 8, minus 8 into 4 is minus 32, divided by 4. That is equal to 6 plus or minus, how much? 36 minus 32 is 4, divided by 4. See, you have a value, root of 4 is how much? 6 plus or minus, root 4 is equal to 2, root 4 is equal to 2, divided by 4. See, that is equal to 6 plus 2 divided by 4 or 6 minus 2 divided by 4. 6 plus divided by 4 means 8 divided by 4 or 6 minus 4 divided by 4. 8 divided by 4 is 2 or 4 divided by 4 is equal to 1. So, here the roots see, they are distinct. See, it's not different, 1 and 2. And they are real numbers. See, distinct and real. Roots are distinct and real. The question may be like this. You have to find the nature of the roots and also find the value of the roots. Like that, the question may be there. Okay? Like this, we can find the discriminant of the roots. So try to understand all these questions. Okay? Write the notes what I sent. So you have to write that notes in your book very neatly. Okay? Next, let us see one more question. 2x square plus kx plus 3 is equal to 0. One question, see, 2x square plus kx plus 3 is equal to 0. Find the value of k here and such that they have equal roots. They have equal roots. If the roots of the equations are equal, equal means same number, two roots are same number comes, then it is they are called equal roots. Then if the roots are equal, what is the value of k? Which value of k gives the roots equal? So first let us find out the value of k. How to find the value of k? See, here a is equal to b is equal to k in the place of k. See, ax square, a is equal to plus bx, bx means plus kx in the value of k, b it is k, and c is equal to 3. Correct? Yes. What is b square minus 4ac? B square minus 4ac. If the roots are equal, what should be the value? See, if the roots are equal, b square minus 4ac must be, if the roots are equal and real, b square minus 4ac must be equal to 0. Correct? Therefore, b square minus 4ac is equal to 0, that gives you the value of k. See, what is b here? B is equal to k. In the place of b, k is that k square minus 4 into a is equal to 2 into c is equal to 3 is equal to 0. Therefore, k square minus 4ac, minus 4 into 2, minus 8 into 3. Minus 8 into 3, minus 24, minus 8 into 3, minus 24 is equal to 0, isn't it? Therefore, k square minus 24 is equal to 0, therefore k is equal to, k square is equal to 24 and k is equal to root 24. So 24, how you can you divide that 24 like this? K is equal to root 24. What is root 24? Can you solve this root 24? See, you can write like this, 4 into 6, correct? So, 24 you can write as 4 into 6, 24. If you bring this 4 outside the root sign, it becomes 2. Value of root 4 is 2. What is that here? 6. So this is a value of k, root 2 root 6. So the value 2 root 6 makes or gives the roots equal, 2 equal roots. What should be the value of k to make this equation having equal roots? So the value 2 root 6 to this k, in the place of k, if you write 2 root 6, then that equation gives you the equal roots. Okay, like this we can find the value of k. So this is about to find the value of k. I hope so. Today we have studied, let us recall what we have studied, how to find the roots of the quadratic equation using quadratic formula or formula method, and how to find the nature of the roots and what happens, which are the different nature of the roots if discriminant is more than 0 or equal to 0 or less than 0, what about the nature of the roots, and how to find the nature of the roots without solving that question, or using discriminant d square minus 3c, or how to find the discriminant of the equation. So this is what we have studied today. So try to understand this question topic. I will send the notes. You have to write that notes in your notebook. Okay. See you in our next video. Okay. See you. Thank you.